Guys, I'm Yashna Singhania, and today Amya and I are going to speak on the topic sustainable architecture. Through our presentation, we are going to take you through the following topics. These would be: what is sustainable architecture? What sustainable strategies do architects focus on? Why sustainable architecture is the need of the hour? Economic and social advantages of sustainable architecture. Examples of sustainable architecture, green building materials that can be used for construction while keeping in mind sustainability, sustainable architecture and the UN SDG goals, and lastly, sustainable architecture with special focus to sustainable architecture in India. So you might be wondering, what is sustainable architecture? Sustainable architecture is architecture that seeks to minimize the negative environmental impact of buildings by efficiency and moderation in the use of materials, energy, development space, and the ecosystem at large. Sustainable architecture uses a conscious approach to energy and ecological conservation in the design of the built environment. The idea of sustainability or ecological design is to ensure that our present use of available resources does not end up having detrimental effects to our collective well-being or making it impossible to obtain resources for other applications in the long run. Sustainability is a buzzword that has already infiltrated many industries, with construction being a major contributor in global energy consumption. It is no surprise that sustainable architecture has become a leading consideration in how buildings and cities are built. Now, architects are challenged not only in crafting a design that excels in form and function, but also in being able to come up with integrated solutions that take into account environmental factors. Sustainable architecture is also referred to as green architecture or environmental architecture. It challenges architects to produce smart designs and use available technologies to ensure that structures generate minimal harmful effects to the ecosystem and the community. To help you understand what sustainable architecture is in simple words, imagine that there is a plot of land that you think is conveniently located for you to build your house. The problem, however, is that there are 100 trees planted on it, and that these trees are the last of their kind. If sustainability is not a concern to you, what you'll probably do is cut down all the trees to clear the space and use the wood to build your house, not caring if anybody else gets the chance to use the same kind of trees in the future. However, this is the opposite of sustainable architecture. Sustainable architecture means putting environmental factors into consideration. If you're in such a situation and you care about sustainability, you would ask yourself these following questions. Is there a nearby piece of land that you could use instead? How can you use some of the wood from the trees without completely depleting the entire plantation so others can get benefit? Could you perhaps still build your house in the space without cutting down all the trees? These are just some factors that should be considered when approaching the sustainable concept in design and construction. Sustainable architecture needs to recognize the existing natural resources and environmental conditions in the construction site and how to incorporate these into the build. Next, I will talk on what strategies that sustainable architecture focuses on. These would be passive sustainable design, active sustainable design, renewable energy system, green material buildings and finishes, native landscaping, and stormwater management. So, passive sustainable design. Passive strategies such as considering sun orientation and climate when siting and being thoughtful about window placement and operation are used to best manage daylighting and natural ventilation and go a long way in reducing energy requirements for the building. In certain climates, thermal mass techniques can be used to harness solar energy. In such cases, thick walls absorb heat from the sun during the day and release it into the building at night. Active sustainable design. Architects consult with mechanical and electrical engineers to implement high efficiency electrical, plumbing, HVAC, which is an acronym for heating, ventilation, and air conditioning, and other systems which are designed to have small environmental footprints. Renewable energy systems. renewable energy systems, including those that harness solar and wind energy, are also great options for some buildings. These systems are often used in conjunction with passive design strategies. Green building materials and finishes. By making it a priority to purchase steel, lumber, concrete, and finishing materials such as carpets and furnishing from companies that use environmentally responsible manufacturing techniques or recycled material, architects up the ante on sustainability. This strategy focuses on using materials that are eco-friendly for the environment. Native landscaping. Landscaping choices can make a big impact in civil building water consumption. By using trees, plants, and grasses that are native to the area, architects can greatly reduce irrigation needs. Landscaping can also be used as a part of a passive energy strategy. By planting trees that shade the roof and windows during the hottest times of the day, solar heat gain inside the building can be reduced. Lastly, we come to stormwater management. When rain falls on an untouched site, the water that doesn't evaporate absorbs back into the ground, replenishing the natural water table. However, when the building is placed on a site along with parking lots, sidewalks, access roads, and other hardscaping, rainfall behaves differently. The water runs off these surfaces and into storm drains. By implementing stormwater management strategies, such as pervious pavements that help to reduce runoff and retention ponds that capture runoff and slowly release water back into the ground, the negative environmental impact of buildings can be reduced. Today, sustainable architecture is really important because it focuses on maximizing energy consumption, minimizing damage to the environment, and it is also proven to be cost-effective. Sustainable architecture is also the need of the hour because of conservation and restoration of natural resources, reduction in energy consumption and waste, protection of ecosystems and environmental biodiversity, and also improvement of air and water quality. After all these advantages that sustainable architecture has, I would also say that there are economic and social advantages to sustainable architecture. Some of these are reduction in long-term costs and dependence on traditional energy sources. This is because, for example, suppose you have installed a solar panel in your house. The initial cost of installation would be high, but the subsequent cost of paying monthly electric bills would be low, and therefore, it is only going to be a one-time investment and not a redundant fees as in the traditional energy supply that we get. Second, improvement in productivity of inhabitants. This goes hand in hand with the quote, live and let live. Since the residents of sustainable architecture are living in nature, with nature, their productivity increases because eco-friendly architecture reduces pollution, atmospheric heat, and also surrounding noise. Upgrade asset and property values. In today's times, the government values properties that are more eco-friendly and in tune with the sustainable development goals. Moreover, consumers are more conscious about sustainability now, and they prefer to live in sustainable structures rather than the traditional and unsustainable ones. Therefore, when the property is put out into the market, its value increases. We also have the advantage of competitive advantage. It also improves the living conditions, health, and comfort of inhabitants. Sustainable architecture ensures a reduction in the use of unnatural goods like cement and plastic, which are detrimental to the human health. When people live in sustainable structures with increased oxygen levels and reduced carbon dioxide levels, lower pollution, lower noise, and lesser heat produced by machinery, health conditions improve. It also leads to an improvement in air and water quality and minimizes demand on local utility infrastructure. The rest of the presentation would be taken over by Amya. Over to Amya.
Thank you, Yashna. So sustainable architecture is not a very futuristic or faraway dream, but can be seen everywhere around us. It's where the turmoil of urbanization meets the serenity of nature. So some examples of sustainable architecture include solar panels, in which the panels absorb sun's energy and use it as another form of energy. Vertical gardens, in which plants grow on vertical panels. Wind turbines, an excellent example of which can be Bahrain's World Trade Centers, terrace gardens, natural building materials, and eco-friendly designs. So sustainable and green building materials that are used in construction are the very core of sustainable architecture. We use usual building materials like bricks, cement, and we consider them essential. However, they can be replaced by more environment friendly materials like bamboo, precast concrete slabs, which are more sustainable, affordable, and avoid structural faults, cork, which is inherently more sustainable, renewable, and biodegradable, straw bales that take up little energy to manufacture, recycled plastic, reclaimed wood and steel, which reduces the devastating impact of deforestation and keeps the valuable resources to ourselves. We also have plant-based polyurethane rigid foam, which is a more sustainable and non-toxic version of rigid foam, which is used for insulation. We have sheep's wool, hempcrete, and terrazzo. Hempcrete absorbs more carbon dioxide than it emits, and it has properties like fire resistance and insulation. Terrazzo is a well-known material in the industry for its sustainability and eco-friendly material. As it's natural and not very artificial, it does not contain any VOC, which is volatile organic compounds. So coming to sustainable architecture and the sustainable development goals. So the United Nations has a collection of 17 sustainable or global goals that are more eco-friendly and sustainable for the whole world. Sustainable architecture fills up to 9 of these goals. These 9 goals include decent economic growth, which is building green offices, providing jobs, boosting the economy, good health, enhancing health, well-being, and productivity, innovation and infrastructure, resilience towards climate change through new innovation, affordable energy, which is using renewable sources of energy, sustainable cities, responsible consumption, which is using resources with care, climate action, which is fewer emissions, that is against climate change, life on land, enhancing biodiversity, saving water, protecting forests, and partnership for goals by creating sustainable buildings. So now we come to sustainable architecture with a focus on India. Can we or can we not? So sustainable architecture in India is still a very new concept. Designing with nature on one hand makes us take into consideration many more elements and factors that we traditionally might not take up, like sun paths, shade trees, rock formations. This is something that usually architects do not take up. So there, and we still have to prioritize the needs of people. So you can see how that might be really difficult here. There has been a surge in sustainability in India, and India has the second largest market for sustainable and green buildings now. And this initiative, surprisingly, was not government driven, but market driven. So it's something the people wanted for themselves. This was just a can we part of it, but can't we part is that there is an urgent need for technological understanding and incorporating socio-cultural aspects. We cannot miss the gap between technology and economy. Sustainable architecture in India, as of now, is a luxury a few can afford, and the affordable, sustainable ways we do have, like mud huts, do not fill urban aspirations. Like the urban areas we live in now, we cannot imagine mud huts just going through apartments, can we? So sustainable architecture is something that is not just sustainable, but affordable and technology-based. Now we have a few facts we would like to tell you about sustainable architecture. If people worldwide switch to energy-efficient light bulbs, the world would save 915 crore rupees annually. Recycling 1 ton of paper saves 2,584 liters of oil, 26,498 liters of water, and 2.5 cubic meters of landfill space. People who live in Australia, Australians, could save up to 800,000 megaliters of water, which is more than the whole Sydney Harbour, just by using more water-efficient appliances and products. Yashna.
Thank you, Amya. Transportation and housing make up 60% of the carbon footprint of US households. This is due to the fuels used for transportation and to heat, cool, and power homes. Lighting accounts for 15% of global electricity use. Switching to LEDs would use 90% less energy and lasts far longer than incandescent lights. Native grasses save water as they require less watering than lawns.
So with this, we come to an end of our presentation. We can see how just one small step from our side could make a global impact and save the Earth, because we only have one Earth. Thank you.